Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Pac-Craft SMP. Today is a very special episode because it is episode 20 here on the Pac-Craft series. So today we're going to do a world tour. We're going to hopefully cover everything that is in this world, on the server world, and every kind of little mechanic, every little base, every little nook and cranny. We're going to try to see how far we've come since the beginning. So first things first, we have the sheep. This sheep, you see, does not have a name, but it's been on this tree since day one. It sat here on this tree, don't know how it got up here, I think it climbed up or something, but yeah, that's the first thing, and the most important. Also, we got our house here. This is my main base for now. We got the villagers, and hopefully we're going to show off all the other bases as well. I guess I should mention that. I'm going to show off every single thing. Every single thing on the server. So if this is a long video, that would be why. So we got LeBron James and Jeff, because I couldn't think of any better names. We got my second floor with some brewing stands, anvils, and my big fancy bed with Luigi on my painting for some reason. And up here we got an enchanting table. So that's the main two floors there. Downstairs, we got chest room. Oh yeah, up here, I guess the main floor. We also have some sinks, I guess they're supposed to be, and a boat, because I like boats. And okay, so down here, we got staircase down. This is the basement where I have all of my stuff all organized and in chests. Because new items come out, like in 1.9 and whatnot, I built this in 1.7, so do have to add some more chests in eventually in the future. But yeah, we also got a little furnace area if we ever need to smelt stuff. So that's the basement. Down here, this little ladder, I don't think I've ever showed this. We got some extra storage for chests. For right now, there's just some stone in there. And farther down, there's just a little black room that I had made for spawning. Maybe we can change it into something in the future, though. Down here, even farther, I got some command blocks to teleport to places that don't work anymore, just back in the day. And if we keep going down farther, we have a little water slide down this large staircase into our train room. I'm not sure exactly what I used to call it. I think it's just the train room, or the train station, rather. I built this probably one of the first episodes, I think episode 5 or something. It just goes to different people's houses. This one is going to go to the castle. Some go to, like, other people's bases, like Logan's house and Veritorium's house. We also got the Nether portal. I don't think I'll show off the Nether or the End. Maybe the End, but not the Nether, because there's not really anything there. It's just the Nether. Nothing too fancy there. So this is my main base. This is my main house where I have all my stuff. We got my Pac-Man swimming pool with a big P on it with in glowstone. Come here often to take a nice cool swim. We got my helipad. For some reason, I just wanted to build a helipad. But right here, we also got a little train or a little minecart going in a loop to these chests that have carrots and potatoes and seeds and wheat. Got a little bridge here. Because why not? And this is the automatic farm. You just pull this lever, water comes down and washes away all the stuff, and that minecart that's going in a loop picks it all up. I guess it's a minecart hopper as well. Picks all the stuff up, and then we have to replant it. But then, yeah, so we get pretty good stuff from that. That was the main island over there. Now, on the second island that I own over here, we got the blacksmith beside the castle. This is kind of going to be a village eventually, but for now it's just a population of one, because the blacksmith lives here. So this is the blacksmith. Say hi.
Hello.
And we got not really much blacksmithing going on. He's kind of lazy, but we got a little smeltery here, some anvils and furnaces, and some iron swords and pickaxes, I guess. Eventually I might set this up so that he'll sell stuff, but for now he's just kind of lazy. And this is my main project that I've been working on for a while now. This is the castle. My main, eventually will be my main base. I don't know. Actually, maybe it won't be. But yeah, this is the main castle with our huge drawbridge, with a tiny little door, obviously. And to the right and left, we have some storage areas, some armor stands, like an armory, I think this is. And then over here, we got some more storage areas. And then up the staircase, we have the main throne room. Wait, what is it? We know what you did. What? Why is there a watermelon that says we know what you did? All right. Don't know what that's about. Okay. We also got PacManPlays here in glass on the front. And then on the side here, we got like a little sun and moon thing that I built. I'm not sure if I want to keep it or not yet. Still don't know. But yeah. Here's my main throne that I sit upon and tell people what to do. I'm just like, blah, blah, blah. And I did have a little dance party. Here we got a banquet table with some cups and some cake, because everyone loves cake. And we got our little torture chamber right here for my entertainment. Yeah, we can drop them in whenever we please, if we so do wish. And then in the back here, we got some more walls and some more watchtowers that aren't finished. And in the back, we have a little area, which I'll probably turn into like a little fancy like boutique garden kind of thing. These are the watchtowers that I built a few episodes ago. Got some like sniping equipment, I think. Yeah, some bows and arrows. If we want to come up here and snipe things, we have that available. So that's the main two islands where I live. Oh wait, there's still the mine. I forgot. Down here is the mine, which I do most of my where I get most of my resources, lots of stone, and diamonds and whatnot. Not too much mined out, but nice little area. I'm pretty sure slime spawned down here as well, somewhere around there. So we might have to set up a thing for that sometime. To get up, we have a minecart thing, which we also set up a while ago. If you just hold right click, it sends you up really, really fast. That's basically the point of that. Over here, we got our sheep farm down this little staircase, where we're gonna eventually have like every type of wool. Still in work progress. It's not finished yet. I had some help. So basically we're gonna get all the colors of sheep, and then we can shear them to get all the colors of wool. I think it'll be pretty efficient eventually. And eventually I'll set it up so other people can harvest if they would like to as well, but they have to pay a price, obviously. Nothing's free in this world. Over there is Veritorum's base, which we're gonna go to pretty soon here. Down here, I think, is to the end portal. Yeah, from last episode, when I fought the Ender Dragon. There's not really anything else here. Yeah, that's about it on my main two bases. So if we continue over to here, this little wrecked thing is Zach's old base. Zach the Lumberjack, his old base, but it got ruined for some reason. I don't know. He moved out to over here, so he didn't move too far. He moved over here to this little base with some big cobblestone walls and some creepers. So in here, he's got a horse, I guess, and a little swimming pool, and chests and anvils, and a thing that says Rip Toast, June 6th to June 12th. The best bunny a man could have asked for. To the memories, heart sack. Alright. In the back here, he's got a little farm. And a bunch of cows for harvesting. And up here, up this little waterfall, we got some armory, his beds, and some junk, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, so that's Zach's base. And across this little path you may have seen... Oop, I'm stuck in the door. There we go. Across this little path here, he has a little orange hut over here, which is just like a little... Lumberjack builds. You can pay for to get certain types of builds done if you would like. And here's the minecart thing from before, which leads to various places. So that's Zach's base and his old base. So if we continue over here, he's got a secret base. It's not very secretive, but you know, he's got a little Z in there, kind of, I guess. That's just his secret base for I don't know what. Anyway, yeah. So if we continue over here, we have my cousin's Jessica's house. A big dirt thing, I guess. They don't play very often, so they're kind of don't have very much stuff. But yeah, that's their little base. I guess if we continue over here, this is the main area, which will probably take the longest. We have the main spawn area, which I built probably, I think the very first day that we got the server, I think I built this. What's this little dirt thing? Oh, okay. Got a little thing over here. What's this say? Zach the Lumberjack was here. Alright. I think I remember that. Got the nether portal that leads to like the main nether area, but as I said before, it's not very important or cool. Got some command blocks that don't work. And yeah, so that's just the main little spawn area. Down here, I think I showed this in the very first episode. No, I haven't worked on it since, actually. It's a little spawning area that you can actually collect resources from. Because back in the day, we had a plugin that allowed us to make any sort of spawners that we wanted. So we made like every mob type of mob spawning thing. Yeah, I don't think I've worked on it since. So there's like also a little enchanting thing, I guess, as well. I haven't been down here for a long time, actually. So yeah, so if we go to like creeper, it has like this big thing set up with chests. And there's like a creeper spawner up here that we just spawned in because we had a plug-in. And then they spawn. I think there's a little spawning room up here. The only reason I'm showing this is because it took so long to make. I think every one of these took about two to three hours to make each. So we stand up here, creepers spawn, and they fall to their death, and you collect their drops and resources. Yeah, so as you can see, they just fall to their death. I don't think anyone even knows this is here besides like me and Travis. Yeah, it's actually a really good place to get resources, but no one really uses it anymore. I think back in the day, people used to use it. Up through here, we have these little floaty islands. I have a little ladder going up, just in case you love ladders, which I do. So there you go. But we're in creative, so it's easy peasy. So yeah, so we built this probably, yeah, I think one of the first things as well. Yeah, we have, okay, it's all coming back to me now. So Travis built this. It's a little fast, easy, like, XP spawner. You can just kill things and collect resources if you want from animal drops. So that's that. And then up over this little cobblestone thing, we have animal spawners, which no one really uses anymore either. I don't know why. It's actually a really good place to get, like, meat and animal drops. It has, like, I think every animal and mob. Or no, it has slimes, wolves, horses, chickens, cows, pigs. I think it even has squids, yeah. Even has squids, has everything. But yeah, I built this very, very early, before I even started the series as well. So yeah. Over here we have a little minecart track that leads to stuff that Logan's built. Logan's built a lot of stuff on the server as well. Probably even more than me, actually. So he has the dripping knife in. I'm pretty sure that it's done. But it's basically just a pub that he made. Where you can sit down and you can buy food and potions from him. And I think you can also rent a room through here. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to show this or not, but yeah, you get like rooms. You can have stuff, I guess. Rent a room if you are poor and don't have a house yet. I assume that's what that's for. And then over here we have a trading system that me and Logan built. Basically, there should be two people on each side. If you want to trade something without, like, being trustworthy. If you're not trustworthy, then you basically put an item in there. The other person puts an item through there. They both flick a button or the lever. And when it's both the levers are on and you want to accept the trade, then the water drops it down and then you can collect it. Yeah, so that's basically how that works. It's kind of confusing, but anyway. If we continue over here, I think it was about episode 9 or 10, We did a Travis's Captain Kirby's base tour, which is just over here. But I think he's added some stuff since last time. He's got a little Captain Kirby pixel art thing. So this is his main base. Awesome base of awesome, apparently. So this is like the main floor. And then up here he's got like a little bedroom with diamond blocks. And then down here, or through here, I'm just kind of going through this fast because we've already, there's a previous episode of this world, or of his base. I think it's about the same. He's got a little redstone museum with like every redstone block. And then through here, he's got more redstone contraptions, I think. He's got some like buttons. Oh, he's here. Hi, Travis. Wait, let's see if I can type faster. Hi, Travis. He's building something, I guess. I don't know what he's building. Kind of looks like a death trap, to be honest. But over here, he's got like a little thing that switches out. Oh no, it's dark now. Switches out stone for red, or for glowstone. That's basically his base. I think he's got some, he's got this automated farm. Kinda is similar to my automated farm. It's just water that pushes away the wheat, or the crop, and puts them all into this one chest. I wonder if I can use it. Probably not. Probably wouldn't like that. He's got some other stuff. I think that's about Travis's base. Oh yeah, he's got a little treehouse up here as well. I think that's new. I don't know exactly what it is. He's got a little horse stable here, and a little railway there as well. All right, if we continue on over here, I think we're about half done all the bases. There's a little, I don't know what that is. Oh wait, what's this? This doesn't look good. This is like a Herobrine I Have Awoken thing that someone built a while ago. I don't know, I think Travis built that, yeah. There's like a little trail of blood that leads to this building. I don't think it's done yet, but it's supposed to be like a little mini story. That's pretty cool. Over here, we got Logan's base. It's freaking huge. As you can see, this like that house is connected to that, so it like goes down. But yeah, we got a Mega Man miner, or the Mega Man. That's Logan's channel, is the Mega Man miner. We got a Mega Man pixel art. He's got like a little wall. Cool. And then, this is new. I haven't seen half of this stuff. He's got a little purper building, I guess. So this is his main house here. It's a big log cabin. He has lots of cool stuff in here, actually. He's got a doorbell. I don't know if you can hear that, but yeah, it's pretty cool. So if we go inside, this is the main room. He's got a little library, I think, with all his, most of his stuff. He's got a little computer with a mouse, and he's got a printer, which is really cool, actually. It's a banner with a stone slab. And up here, he's got more stuff. He's got like a little checkerboard. That's cool. And he's got all the Harry Potters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and some sand. And he's got like a little nook for reading your book, I guess, up there as well. This used to be a pool table that had like signs as the sticks. And that looked really cool, but I think the signs got destroyed somehow. Anyway, and I think this is supposed to be a widescreen TV. I'm not sure. I have to ask him. But anyway, if you continue down this staircase, he's got a little lava room, or a little lava area that goes down to his mine. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, that's his little mine area. Over down here and around, he has this little area that's not finished. He told me what it was at one point, but I really don't remember. I think it was supposed to be a storage room? No, wait, I don't know. Something. Something there. He's got an automated furnace thing here that fills it up with 64 coal all constantly. I think we can see it up here, actually. Yeah, so it's just a minecart that picks up coal from this chest, automatically distributes it. That's pretty cool. In here, geez, I'm like getting lost in this place. In here, he's got a little armory with like all different kinds of stuff. And here, I don't know what this is actually. I think it's a villager trading area. Yeah, looks like it, where you can trade with your villagers. Down here, he's got I believe. Oh, yeah. Storage room. This is the storage room. With all his stuff. Look how many diamonds he has. He has, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stacks of diamonds. I'm so jealous. And over here, he's got, like, a little blocked-off area. I'm not sure what that's for. I don't really want to find out, to be honest. And, up through here and around, I think this is... Oh, yeah. This is, like, the enchanting area. A bunch of stuff. I don't know. And over here, he's got like a little cobblestone gen with like infinite water source. And I don't know what this is. I don't know what that is supposed to be. Over here, he's got a kitchen. Yeah, this is the kitchen. You can get flint and steel. And you can cook your food. And there's like a fridge here that shoots out food. That's pretty cool. And some taps. And then out here, this is the balcony that you would have seen before from out here. So he's got a big base that goes straight down and has a lot of stuff. A lot of cool stuff. A lot bigger than my base, to be honest. And then from over here, he's got... I don't know. Why is everything, like, blocked off? I don't know what this is supposed to be. It's just blocked off. I kind of want to go see what it is, but I'm not going to. Yeah. So that's Logan's base. He's got a huge base. This is actually... There's actually more to his whole area, but this is just his main house, humble abode. Over here, he's got some stables, which are pretty cool. Over through here, he's got a little bridge. That... Oh, what's this say? Mr. Chicken Rip, 2015 to 2015. He was a good man. I mean chicken. I think I wrote that a while ago. I don't know. Someone wrote that. Who knows? He's got some farms over here. He's got a little train station connected to mine. And some wheat. Oh, is this supposed to be a melon farm? Maybe that's from the melon before. Maybe I didn't take all the melons. Maybe someone took all the melons, but and then he thought it was me. I don't know. Maybe that would explain it. Over here, we've actually shown this. This is his arena. It's really cool. I think me and him did a battle like way, way long ago as well in one of the episodes. Yeah, it's just a little arena where you can fight. He actually updated it. Has lava now, so it's even more deadly. He's got another little bridge. And up over around here, he's got a little like commune area, I think, where you can like... I don't know. Before you were able to like buy stuff, but I think he took that down. Yeah, he did. Fairly recently, there's like XP here still. Alright. Yeah, and then over here, this is the main banquet area that he has with a bunch of cake and cups and stuff and a nice chandelier, actually. Wow. Fancy. And this is the last thing, I believe. And it's just like a big... I'm not exactly sure what it is, but it's like a big... cylinder silo sort of thing with like a little fire thing. I don't know, you'd have to ask him what it is. I'm not entirely sure what it is, because I don't remember. I think it's 1.9. he set off this like hay thing because you don't take damage when you fall on hay anymore. They added that. So yeah, so this is Logan's base. Oh wait, there's still more stuff. Come on, he's got like a huge base, man. He's got like a little bridge here, which I really like, and a waterfall. Yeah, and then he's got some stone thing there. Don't know what that is exactly. And I think this used to be his old mine. Yeah, that used to be his old mine, I believe. Yeah, so that's Logan's base. It's way nicer than... I think this is probably the best base, to be honest. I hope he sees this, because I really like his base. It's, like, probably the best base. Oh, this is also Travis's stuff. He's got, like, a little Captain Kirby's deals. You can buy like you can exchange things, so you can exchange like 64 redstone for 3 gold and stuff. I don't know, I guess. And then there's like a creative builds. He has lots of signs. All right, so you can get him to buy like build stuff and whatnot. So yeah, so that's main stuff. Looks like he's building. Oh yeah, that's the glowstone and stone thing that would switch out. He's still there. I think if we go over here, I think there's one more base. There's like a little temple there. Or there's a few more. I think there's 2 more bases. This is my friend Andrew's base. He plays on sometimes. And I don't know what's in this hole. Alright, so this is his main base. He doesn't play too often, but he's got a cool little base here with like a map of his house. And he's got like a little secret area. And a horse stable. And a bedroom with a creeper head. That's cool. I wonder how he got that. And a little balcony. This is a really nice house as well. Looks like he has a little work in progress build there. And he's got a little mob farm too. So that's Andrew's base. It's pretty small, but it's pretty cool. I really like that house design as well. I think there's one more base left to go. We just have to fly over there. It is Veritorium's base. Alrighty here, so we're approaching Matthew's base. As you can see, he's got a little pixel art of his skin as well on the ground there. So he actually plays probably the most out of everyone. He has a lot of stuff. He has a lot of stuff. He has a big farm there. He's got some little buildings. He's got a big melon farm, I think, and pumpkin farm there, yeah. He's got an old temple that he built beside. This is his main base here. If we go inside, he's got some cool stuff. He's got a panic room, and he's got all his storage stuff here. Upstairs, he has, Travis is cheating for some reason, an enchantment area with like a bed, I think. I think this is supposed to be a race car bed. I might just be making that up. I really don't know. Up over here, if I can fly, he's got a little room over here, which you may have seen out of the side. It's like a little cylinder with another portal. Alrighty, and then got some cool water streams. And then out from over there and up, he's got like a little this is the sniper tower. I can't do accents, but if I could. So we got a little sniper tower there, and then an even higher sniper tower, I guess, with a glass path, the Z observatory, going over to this big thing, which I believe, oh yeah, it's the casino. If you couldn't tell, it says casino. So it's like this big cobblestone cylindery, cakey, stacked, layered thing, which is cool. He's got like slot machines and stuff, and I think that's about it. It just goes up and up for a long time. Oh yeah, he's got a little pool table here. This is what Logan had with the signs and stuff. And I think the rest of it's empty, but it's just this huge layered cake, layered thing. Yeah, there we go, at the top. Yeah, so I think that's about Matthew's base. He's also got a huge map room, which is really cool. He also has like a tree farm over there, but he has this huge map room, which has like most of the whole world. I kind of wanted to do this, but maps kind of lag out the server, so he can just have his map and then everyone can just come and look at his. But he filled out most of it, actually. This is probably, so this is where I am. And to put it in perspective, this is his base, and that's my base with the castle over there. And that's, whose base is that? I don't know whose base that is. That's Logan's base. That's Travis's base. That's Andrew's base, I think. So yeah, to put it in perspective, there's like quite a big area. Or it's a big area that we live in. Lots of water and lots of sand, basically. But yeah. Also, I guess I'll just mention this, but over off to the, which direction is it? To the east, there is like a huge ice spikes biome as well as a mesa with colored clay. So that's where we get most of that kind of stuff. There's one last thing. I almost forgot. This is like the best thing. Oh my god, I can't believe I almost forgot. Alright, so you guys are probably wondering, what is this thing behind me? What is the special thing that I almost forgot about? So this is the thing that me and Zach have been working on for quite a while. We're not even close to being finished it, but it's this huge project, and I'm super excited to announce it that we're working on it. Hopefully it's going to get done. It may never even get finished, but me and Zach are really excited to actually finish it, maybe someday. So here it is. Da, 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 da. So you guys are probably wondering, what the heck is this thing? It's a big platform. It's a big stone and cobblestone platform. Well, as you can see, it is. But what we're turning it into is even more. We're going to turn it into Disneyland. It's going to be Disneyland, guys. We're going to make a huge Disneyland, hopefully to scale, or not to scale, but hopefully pretty close to scale. And it's hopefully going to have everything that Disneyland has and most of the working stuff that Disneyland has. The roller coasters probably won't be as exact and stuff like that. But we're going to build like almost everything that it has. It's going to be a huge, huge area. And this is just the starting of it. Where first we're building out like a huge, huge, huge stone platform to start. And then we'll start building most of Disneyland to plan everything out where everything's going to go. And yeah, so me and Zach are super excited to hopefully maybe someday finish it. Right now we're just working on it. And yeah, super exciting. Super, super exciting. I'm super excited to hopefully get it finished someday. To put this in perspective, there's this huge square you see here. Just what's filled in took about 3 hours. So the reason it takes so long is because it's in the water, we have to like press shift and go like this over the water and do that like the whole way around. So it takes like way, way longer than if it was on land, but it's a lot better in the water here because it won't, be laggy. It'll only be laggy when people are actually here, but when the chunks aren't loaded and people aren't here, it won't be loaded. So it won't be laggy. So that's the only reason we did it so far out in the middle of the ocean here. But yeah, we're super excited to get working on it. I hope you all enjoyed this world tour. I was super excited to do it. And I'm super excited to maybe in the future we could do another one where I kind of show you guys what there's been updated on the server world. So, hope you all enjoyed. If you haven't already, make sure to like and subscribe and share with your friends. And maybe someday we'll finish this Disneyland. Hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!